Well, hey there, everybody. Welcome to this game I've never played before. It's called The Binding of Isaac Afterbirth Cross. Of course, I'm being facetious. Hello, everybody. Welcome back to The Binding of Isaac Afterbirth Plus here. You might be wondering exactly what's going on. First off, here's the seed day. It's going to be Echo Charlie Foxtrot 29 Mike 86. Got the wooden nickel and the belt, and also cat ears for some reason. So you might be wondering exactly what the heck is going on. Why have all of a sudden has Isaac come back? Well, if you have not watched the channel update video that I posted either this morning or last night, depending on what time it actually got done processing, then you may not have known that the channel is going to be coming back. Not that I ever went anywhere, of course, but the conclusion that I came to, and again, I'm just going to summarize what I talked about in the channel update video. The conclusion that I came to is that essentially I don't think that I'm hurting anyone but myself and the fans by not putting out videos. YouTube and Google, they're not going to change. They're just flat out never going to change. The day that I'll believe that change is in effect for video game YouTubers out there on YouTube in particular, will be the day when Google and YouTube actually communicate their ideas, are very open and clear and concise in their intentions of implementing new stuff that nobody asked for, and on top of that, of course, trying to want to actively improve the systems that they already have in place. Until that happens, I have settled on the idea that the YouTube situation will never improve for my channel, just bottom line. And again, I'm only speaking about stuff that concerns my channel. I think that's the only thing that I have the right to speak about anyway. So that's it. So in the end, I think that I'm only hurting myself, and I want to get back to enjoying recording YouTube videos and enjoying the games that I record for YouTube videos, including Isaac, which I have not been playing. I've not been playing a lot of Isaac. You might be wondering what happened to the streak. Well, that streak is long gone. I lost that on stream a while ago, a couple months ago, and then I've played a couple of streaks here and there since then that haven't really gone over 10, and I just said, you know what, I want to get a fresh start here, even though this technically, ironically, is not a fresh streak here. But it almost is. Look, that's beside the point. You're just making things up now. I want to get back to just enjoying being on YouTube and creating content, because that's how I started and that's how I will continue to actively work. You know, despite not getting the support from the company that controls everything, of course, which I'm not going to rant into because I've already spoken my piece on that at this point. You know, it's not like well, this sub 40,000 subscriber channel is making a big deal about the adpocalypse. It's, you know, like, oh, we better do something. I'm speaking metaphorically as if I'm Google, but that's essentially how I'm sort of looking at it. I've realized that at this point, nothing's going to change, and I'm hurting myself by not putting anything out, and on top of that, I'm also not going to be able to effectively make money on YouTube anymore, which is why I've been spending the last couple of weeks streaming a whole lot more. The streaming has done very well, of course. Not enough to like take the place of YouTube, obviously, but replacing my YouTube channel with streaming was never my intention and never has been. I'm still working on diversifying my revenue streams to where I can get as much support as possible. And of course, I also have the option open for anyone who does want to actively support myself financially. The ones that who don't, you know, they don't necessarily want to be giving all their money in like direct PayPal form. And they don't want to sign up on Twitch. They don't want to go through Patreon, whatever. I think that it's important to have all kinds of open options for people who do want to help, but they don't necessarily want to help in the ways that I present to them, which is why I'm making the effort to diversify. Increasing the amount of revenue streams that you have is something that all content creators eventually will have to do. I think that it's a very smart way to do business, and of course, also it offers your fans a little bit more options, because I'm very, very lucky to have passionate fans that honestly truly care about me, and I'm also very lucky in the sense that I don't really have to work too hard to convey the idea that I'm in trouble, as far as not financial trouble, but you know, my livelihood is being affected by something important. So, and again, thank you everyone who's been supportive over this whole ordeal stuff that's been going on. You know, it's not really been fun. There's actually been zero fun about it. On top of losing out on lots of money that I could have and should have been making, rightfully so. You know, some people have chosen to stop following me because it's the same dead horse getting beaten over and over again. And I understand that. I would hope that those kind of people would have a little bit more of an understanding mind when it comes to difficulties and whatnot in other people's lives. But if not, you know, I'm not here to cry in my spilt milk. I hope we don't get that item. Careful. So yeah, so Isaac will be coming back. It probably won't be an everyday sort of thing because I just don't have, I don't have enough time to record Isaac on top of getting caught up with all the other content, and I also don't want to play Isaac every single day. But I do certainly want to keep on playing Isaac, and I do certainly want to keep on making sure that people are enjoying Isaac on the channel. Honestly, I think we don't go for a deal with the devil here. As much as I hate to say it, Little Harbingers is an item that I blacklisted, and having the feather here means that we are very, very we're very motivated to get angel deals here. Curse of Lost, hooray! So obviously, with us having blank card, that's going to give us a big time boost in our survivability if we do find something like, say, a Dagaz rune, or even, of course, you're looking for an Algis rune. Hierophant card, of course, means it's basically GG, especially if we're able to combine that with, like, say, the 9-volt or battery or something like that. I'm basically looking for a full charge here so I can steal the mob trap room. And I know that a lot of people were really upset about Isaac going away, and truth be told, I didn't really want to get rid of Isaac, but I've talked about it before, and I guess I'll say it one more time. Isaac is by far the worst performing series on my channel, outside of SS Radio, of course. And Isaac was actually drawing people away from the channel because here's another secret that you guys and gals may not know. If you're a channel around my size, any video that you have that's on the channel that has like 400 or 500 views is really, really bad for the channel. Like, really bad. Not only does the algorithm pick up on that, also it looks awful for your channel's well-being, and it tends to drive people away. So, and I realize that Isaac is pretty much Isaac's. I don't want to say it's a lame duck on YouTube, but unless if you're Ryab, you're not making much off of Isaac. At the same time, though, it's still a game that I enjoy playing. It's still a game that I want to continue to make content for and stuff. So, you know, Isaac, there'll be a peppering here and there of Isaac. Again, I don't expect it to be a sort of, we're going to see one every day sort of thing, of course. In fact, I'll guarantee it won't be, but. You know, there will be some Isaac content here to fill the gaps whenever I'm in between series or if I just feel like playing. So Isaac, it's gonna be a little more casual. That doesn't mean I'm not gonna stop trying though. I mean, I'm gonna still keep on going here. Obviously, the tarot closet is gonna be huge, and here we go. I guess now is it's a great time. It's a great time trying to find my mojo back. Yeah, sure. Let's start off with a blank card Yara rune. I'm 100% okay with this, and also have it be an angel deal run, possibly. Isn't that weird? The blank card Yara tarot cloth means that we're going to double everything twice, which is hilarious. And of course, all I need is one full charge on the ground, and that will give me basically the keys to everything I want, almost quite literally. Back out of here. The super secret room is probably to the right of that room, but I'm not going to really. There's no reason for me to use a bomb. And what are we really going to get that I'm going to replace right now? I'm not going to replace the arrow rune, I can tell you that. I'm not going to replace blank card, I can tell you that. Especially with us having a tarot cloth. That was terrible. Okay, that's even worse that you got hit twice there. Room is like breaking my brain right now. Which is not good because I've been slowly getting back into casting shape with my voice, and I need to not lose my voice. My voice is pretty important. Even though it may not be a good voice, it's not. You know, I'm not here to debate that. I'll leave that up to the philosophers and the Redditors. I do have a subreddit, by the way. I don't think I've ever talked about my subreddit before. I do have a subreddit. You can go to sub. You can basically just r/Invicta. It's not very creative, I know. It's no NLSS circle. You know what? But it is a website that I've been trying to use a lot more. Yeah, we just lost our deal, but to be honest, we probably weren't going to get a deal anyway on this floor. We're not looking for a deal with the devil here. We're looking for a deal with the angel, so not that big of a deal. No pun intended. Total pun intended. Still looking for a full charge on the ground. That is not a full charge, but that is a lot of stuff. I feel like I have to take this pill. One that makes you larger. Probably not one that I'm going to want to take. Again, since we've already lost our deal with the devil, I pretty much don't even care about taking red heart damage anymore right now. So you might be wondering, what does that have to do with you leaving all the soul hearts on the ground? Well, it's because I'm going to get one more full charge here if I can. And basically max out on HP. Even have some HP to give at that point. Very happy with our damage so far. It was nice finding that small rock because we needed a tiers upgrade. Of course, damage is always great. As evidenced by this fatty baddie, like, taking 35 freaking shots to get killed. There we go. You know what? I think the super secret room is going to be here. I'd be mistaken. All right. Well, we're probably not going to get another full charge, so I am going to go grab this key. I'll grab the bombs, grab the soul hearts, and grab the bombs. Might as well buy the soul heart as well. There's no reason not to. So, yeah. I mean, does the Yara blank card combo, does that automatically mean that, like, it's a one run? Probably. But only because of in the essence of what Yara and blank card gives you, which is unlimited everything on the ground. It's hard to really lose whenever you have, like, all it really takes is just one item on the ground with a full charge for me to just blow open the entire run. So, the dream scenario, of course, is finding a golden chest that has an item in it that also has a full charge on the ground in the same room. Whether or not we're going to find something like that, I don't know. If I get an opportunity to break the game like that, I certainly will. Captain Ninetales, by the way, fantastic upgrade for us. I'll take that. Cancer, also great trinket for us. Sorry, I hate to tell you, Feather. I mean, I like you. I really do. But right now, having tiers upgrade is going to be way more important than possibly getting any deals with the angel items there. Now, hopefully, we can find something like, oh, I don't know. Maybe. It's probably worth actually doubling in here. See if there's an item in here. That is just too good. All right. Alright, so what are we going to do now? Well, your boy Sinvicta is very happy now, because that means that we're going to get guaranteed devil items out of those red chests, and most likely we will get every item that I want, and still not have to worry about getting deal with Devil Precedent either. So, yeah, this would be a really good run to come back on. If you haven't watched me play Isaac for a while and you don't watch my Twitch channel, welcome. My name's Sinvicta. I'm a very mediocre Isaac player. Well known for having a 170 whatever it was win streak at one time. It's not well known. Yeah, I don't think I'm well known for anything. I think maybe the thing that I'm most well known for is playing GeoGuessr with Northern Lion. That and the Culling, I guess. We had the Culling had a certain charm to that series. I think that hasn't been matched since me and Ryan have collabed on other games since then. There's something about the survival genre that that was very special with Ryan and I's chemistry on that. That being said, the Culling is pretty much dead. Not as dead as Marvel Hero. I'm really sad about that. And I'm not really sad necessarily because I was playing the game a whole lot anymore, but I did have hundreds of hours in that game. It was a fantastic game. Definitely underrated ARPG of its time. I'm just more sad of, like, you know, the follow-up stuff, that everything that's occurred. If you haven't been keeping up with the Gazillion story, just Google it real quick. I'm not going to go into it. This is not a podcast. At least it's not that kind of podcast. So yeah, we're just going to be doing this for quite a while. It would be nice if we had a full charge or Nun's Habit, Sharp Plug, anything like that. That way I won't have to continually go back there and waste time doing that. It's not really wasting time. It's more of just, you know, spending time over there. I would like to get Boss Rush if possible. So essentially, and if you don't know what I'm doing, or if you're not sure why I'm very excited about that room, the cursed room, basically because since that red chest had an item in it, in Guppy's Paw, that tells me that when we Yared it, that's also going to mean that the chest that we originally Yared also has an item in it, and which subsequently means every time we Yara, every chest that we produce via Yara will, that kind of sucks, will give us a guaranteed item inside of it. And with this not being Curse of the Anything, that means that we're going to very happily be able to open everything we want. So there's Cursed Eye and Guppy's Tail. I wasn't actually I'm being pushed right now. I wasn't actually trying to open up a chest there, but it's good to know that Cursed Eye is right there. Hopefully that means that we're not going to have Cursed Eye in any of the other chests. Now, what may happen... I don't mind taking damage here just because we literally have unlimited HP at this point. Let's go back and do it again. If the question is, well, when are you going to actually open all the chests? I think that now would probably be a good time because I don't really want to waste too much time on this floor. I also need to avoid picking up Cursed Eye if possible. Yeah, so there's 9 lives. There's Pandora's box. I'm being bounced all around here. And actually, it's not spawning any Deal with the Devil items, which is interesting. It's actually spawning a bunch of the regular items. Prayer card, good D20, Ghost Baby. Definitely do not want Epic Fetus. Daddy Longlegs is pretty good. You're probably not being able to see a whole lot right now, and that's okay. I don't blame you. Hey, Pyromaniac's great. Cricket's Body is also very good. I'll definitely take Gimpy. I would love to get 9 lives if possible. Definitely do not want... Oh, Polyphemus is, of course, a great item. Smart Fly here. I would like to get Infestation. We were able to get Proptosis. Celtic Cross as well. Guppy's Collar. Hey, there's Guppy. All right, we got Blank Card. I don't think I was able to get 9 lives. I definitely want 9 lives. We end up getting Cursed Eye, which really sucks. Got Juicy Sack. Of course, I mean, you know, Curse of the Tower is going to be great now with us having actual Pyro. Hey, look, it's another dead cat. So yeah, we have 19 lives. It's good. D100's in there somewhere. We should try to get the D20. I did see it up there. If we can D20 all of the soul hearts on the ground, that'd be good. Completely forgot that we had the tarot cloth, so it would have been smarter for me to actually, like, you know, have picked up one of the chests or two before doubling it, but that's okay. There's another Guppy's head, that's good. I'm gonna use that. D20. Ah, there we go. Okay. Now why is that a big deal? Well, that allows me to hopefully pick up stuff in here to where I'm not being pushed all around like I am right now. We got a luck up, it's great. I'm just gonna slowly absorb everything that I can. Apologies if you're having problems seeing stuff. I don't blame you. There's certainly a lot of stuff going on right now. Don't even ask me what happened to the Ardiera rune. I have no idea, dude. D6 would be quite hilarious right now, although I think it would also be foolish. We got Ipecac. Ipecac's great. Bum Friend is good. I wouldn't mind getting the crystal ball, and we'll just get on out of here, because this is just absolute madness in here right now. Got Arrowwalk. Butt Penny, no thanks. Got the D20. Sure, we'll go ahead and reroll that one. Now, I know what you're asking. You're saying, Zinvicta, are you going to actually reroll this run? Like, as in, like, D4 it or D, like, or D100 it? Probably not. I don't think there's any reason to. Although, I do see that we have a very interesting combo that you may be very privy on right now. We actually have the great combo of Isaac's Heart. There's Isaac's Heart and Blood Rites, which is an automatic win. And I don't think I've ever shown that combo off, actually. Where did Isaac's Heart go? That's the problem. Or did we already have Isaac's Heart? I'm not exactly sure what's even going on anymore. Yeah, okay, we do have Isaac's Heart. So if I get Blood Rites here... There we go. Just get out. I think we got it. Yeah. So yeah, that's a GG. We also got the Emperor card, just because, I mean, hell, why not? And let's see what our tiers are like. We must have picked up Monstro's Lung. All right, well, that's okay, because we don't need to really fire anymore. If you're not sure what's going on, the combo is basically Blood Rites and Isaac's Heart is an instant GG. Why would that be an instant GG, you might ask? Well, it's because Blood Rites is supposed to take HP off of Isaac every time you use the spacebar item. Well, the problem is that because we have Isaac's Heart, we're not actually taking any red heart damage. So essentially, we can just sit here and spam the spacebar over and over again. Blood Rites, by the way, in comparison to other items, does massive, massive amounts of damage. And it's not a combo you get to see that often. And this is actually the first time that I think I've ever showed it off on the channel. So why not? You know, why not? It's a good thing to come back to. We do have 96.8 damage, 86 damage. That's pretty good. Oh, we also have the Sad Bomb combo, which means that theoretically, or Sad Bomb, Cursed of the Tower, and Pyromaniac combo, which essentially means that we are actually indestructible. So we're gonna fly through this run, you know? We don't necessarily have to have fun. Also, I'm not sure what's going on with Isaac's head when he's doing that. I wouldn't mind taking Void. But the thing is, like, if we take Void, that means that we lose Blood Rites. So, well, let me back that up. If we take Void and then Void Blood Rites, we won't be able to spam it over and over again. We would only be able to use Blood Rites every time we have a full charge, which is not exactly what I want. We end up getting little Harbingers, which is something I did not want. I mean, I was actually incorrect on the, Devil Deal item. That's actually called the List or something like that. And basically, you have to kill, in every room, you have to kill mobs in a certain order, and you'll get a benefit of, like, say, like a stat up. You can sometimes get keys or bombs, etc. That wasn't Little Harbingers. Little Harbingers is the item that we just picked up in the Angel Room that I am not a fan of. What exactly are we waiting for here? Oh, host. I didn't even see the host down there. Good old Blood Rites Isaac's Heart. It's funny because I didn't even realize that we had taken Isaac's Heart, but yeah, we don't really need Black Hole. It's alright. Apparently we also got Scatter Bombs at some point. Sure, one up. Why not? I mean, we needed... When you've got 19 lives, you know, you gotta keep your priorities solid. You gotta make sure you cover all your bases in case of the unthinkable happens. I will take the compass, and that's gonna be all she wrote for here. And yeah, we'll just go ahead and go to Mom real quick. If you want to see how much damage Blood Rites does, it's just kind of that right there. The Polaroid, Goathead, sure, why not? And sure, I guess Dark Prince's Crown, why the heck not? Go check out the boss rush. Not exactly what I would consider good. I would have done it if we had like Libra or something like that, but we certainly don't need to waste any time with that. And it will also be a great example to show you all how much damage it does against Hush. This is a very hushable run. And I mean that sincerely. And the fact that we have Infestation 2 on top of the fact that, you know, we have 96 damage. We're going to be doing lots and lots and lots and lots of damage to things very quickly. This is why this combo is so good. It's the strongest combo. Oh yeah, by the way, we can also get free demon judgments. Because again, we're not, Isaac's Heart is completely separate from his body, so we can only be harmed when Isaac's Heart is hit, not when Isaac's body is hit. Right now, we literally can just sit here over and over again. I mean, with 21 lives, is this a one run? Yeah, I'd say it's probably a one run. It's certainly the best type of run that I would love to come back to in celebration of returning to YouTube with Isaac. Acid Baby, I mean, sure, why not? You know, will we be able to break 100 damage on this run? Maybe? Remember, we are guppies, so... Oh, Conquest. Goodbye, Conquest. And Krampus, not going to be too happy. Sure, Olympic Coal, why not? Yeah, we'll just go ahead and take Cricket's Head as well. Yeah, so we're doing 147. It's a pretty decent amount. I mean, it's not great. You know, it could definitely be a little bit better. I'm being facetious here. Of course, this is like a dream come true run. We might as well go check out the Curse Room. It's not like it's going to take us any time to get there. So for those of you who've ever lamented about having Isaac's Heart... And wondered why you hear a lot of YouTubers and streamers talk about this combo. This is the exact reason why. I don't think I need to really explain it anymore than what you're seeing. What you're seeing right here is what you're getting. Yeah, we'll just go down here. And even if we get hit, like, what, are we going to die? You're telling me that Sinvicta can throw a run where he's got 21 lives or more? Not even Scrubvicta could throw a run this good. I firmly believe that. I've thrown my fair share of runs, don't get me wrong. But this is an unthrowable run. What could that possibly be? I don't know. Oh, Mysterious Liquid, of course. Very good Devil Deal item. Did we get... No, we didn't get Chaos. I don't know why we're getting all these non-Devil Deal items in our Devil Room chests, but... Not that it really matters, of course. Blood Bag, I mean... Whatever. If we could get Libra, that'd be hilarious. Got the Bob transformation. Definitely want to hold on to Blood Rites. Yeah, we'll take the Mind. And Jacob's Ladder is pretty good, even though we're probably not going to use it. Take the map here, and definitely want to put some money back. Alright. Let's see how much damage we do against Hush. Good old Hush. I'm trying not to go too ham on the spacebar, because my spacebar is actually pretty loud. Not as loud as the game is right now, of course. I mean, let's just not be crazy. Remember, if we do take a hit, well, we've got Curse of the Tower and Sad Bombs. Which means that, well, basically something like that. That's Explosivo, by the way. I'm not sure if you can tell. And Hush is dead. Yep. One of the fastest Hush kills that I've ever had. Without having the Chaos card. We could do Delirium. If I get a chance to do Delirium after the Cathedral chest, then sure, why not? Why not? We might as well just go full ham here. I think we also got the wafer at some point. Yeah. Yeah, that's a lot of damage. Quite a lot of damage. How's your downtime been? How's your non-Isaac life been? A lot of people have been expressing their displeasure of not seeing Isaac on the channel anymore, and I apologize for it. Hopefully you understand the reason why. There's a lot of things you have to take into account when you're a YouTuber. And even then, like, I still don't consider myself a YouTuber. Like, if I'm I'll start referring to myself as a YouTuber when I can financially be independent from being just doing YouTube content. Hey, fighting Mega Satan is certainly a possibility here. And yeah, we'll go ahead and take Libra. So let's see now what our tiers look like, because our damage went down a whole lot. Pretty good. It's pretty good. Yeah, that'd do. I just want to pop over here. It's a very important point that I go over there and get that super secret room. God's flesh. Hey, we got Spun. Good. We needed Spun. We needed some help on our tiers rate of 2. Sorry, 1. All right. I'm just gonna pop on by here. Number 2. Yeah, we needed more reasons to throw out explosions. Good. The bitrate, by the way, it must look great. It must look HD quality bitrate here. That's a very, very interesting, neat synergy we have. Synergy, it's important. I bet you didn't wake up today thinking that you're going to see an Isaac run where there's not a whole much to say other than just watching the tiers fly. No pun intended. Of course, we already have a 1 tier delay, so we don't really have to worry about Libra balancing too much more. Our damage is adequate. Might be the most damage I've ever seen in this game. Like, might actually be the most powerful run ever. And I've had quite a few runs that are definitely in the running for that title. It's a very exclusive title, of course. But I don't think I've ever had a non-greed run that was this broken this quickly. So might be the strongest ever. Speak of the devil. Now I know what you're saying. You're saying, Invicta, please fight Delirium. Look, if the void pops, I'm going for it. Yeah, I do not want Kidney Stone though. And Blue Baby's dead. There's the void, so obviously we're gonna be doing this. And actually, I got blown into the void, so even if I didn't want to do it, we're doing it. Not over yet, folks. Don't worry. I'm not going to do a full clear, but I definitely will clear all the bosses. Jacob's Ladder is doing a pretty good amount of damage. This is mostly all Jacob's Ladder. This has nothing to do with Ipecac, of course. Now hopefully, let me see if I can find a teleport card. Why do I want a teleport card? Because I don't technically want to, like, I don't want to just run into Delirium and kill him. I would rather, like, fight all the bosses and then kill Delirium. Alright, it's gonna be Isaac. Well, that was Isaac. Yeah, you know what? Let's take Fate's Reward. Why not? Why not? Alright, so it's probably a good bet that this is not going to be Delirium up here. That Nalja's Rune, probably not going to need that. Kano. Looking for the God's Rune, Hagalos. Now, obviously, I could still use... If I wanted to, I could still use the Blood Rites combo. I think we really need to. I mean, where's the fun in that when I can do this, right? Alright, or am I right? Yeah. Alright, there we go. Very good. Alright. Just trying to get to the door here. Showing why I don't like the guillotine. Yeah, we should probably get out of that. Probably could get out of that room before those bombs start dropping. Kinda sad we didn't find a Degas rune, but that's okay. Yeah, rune bag, maybe. Alright, let's play some Binding of Isaac Afterbirth. Afterbirth Plus, excuse me. Now, what would really send this over the top is if we somehow got Mush. Oh my goodness, we got Toxic Shock. If we somehow got Magic Mush, that'd be great. Alright, Cage is not going to make it. He didn't make it. I will grab the speed upgrade because we have Libra. I mean, why not? And hello, Blue Baby. Alright, Blue Baby didn't make it. Yeah, sure, we'll take Contract from below. It might help out. We need some consumables here. There we go. I'll use the Blood Rites combo to just finish off anything that we have here. The guys, there we go. Don't have to worry about Curse the freaking Maze anymore. If you can tell me where Isaac is on the screen right now, please, by all means, show me, because I don't see him. And the guillotine is certainly not making this any easier. The worst Isaac run imaginable. Hello, Bloat. Alright. Great to see you. Now, what do you think Monstro's Lung at a one tier delay with Sad Bombs, Ipecac, and all this stuff looks like when we're firing all at once? Like we're just spamming it. Well, I'll go ahead and let you ask Delirium that here in a second. If you've ever wanted to know what this combo looks like against against a boss that has a lot of HP, well, we've already shown it to you on Hush, and that was before we got crazy. As if this isn't crazy enough already. All right, let's see how long it takes. What will die first, the game, crashing, or Delirium? Not sure where that unicorn poop came from. Not sure of anything right now. You might notice there's a lot of stuff going on. This game does have a lot of finer nuances that you need to know. It's very important that you come into these fights with strategy. You gotta know your strengths and weaknesses. I stopped firing, like, 5 minutes ago, by the way. I want to point that out. There we go. There you go. Thank you for watching, everyone. Hey, look at that. We got a speed run. Let me know what you think down below of the Isaac content returning. Again, thank you. For those of you who did not watch the channel update, please go watch that. It has a lot of really great links down below that you can support my channel in the future and not have to worry about the adpocalypse stuff. So thank you for watching, everyone. Hope you had a great start to your day. And as always, I'll see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody.